Hi everyone, we are going to review basics of Pilates. So in Pilates we are having something we call the abdominal five, the abdominal series, and we can combine these abdominal exercises with a lot of prop, Swiss ball, lilo ball, power circle, elastic, or practically any kind of new accessoire. I could even put yoga block with them. And we have a lot of different levels also available. So now I am just showing you the pure exercise, and I'm trying to explain how you could modify it for more beginner and for more advanced. Let's see. If you want to have more info of this, I'm going to create another study on Pilates. So first of all, you're going to work in imprint. Imprint is not purely pushing down your lower back, but it's contracting the muscles, shortening the distance here, and not letting the belly to bulge out. So if it's like pushing out, then probably you lost some kind of deep connection. You are also having something really important called the C curve. So it's like sometimes you can see people lifting their head in a really bad way. You want to avoid that. You would like to have chin gently lowering down, and with the exhale you come up and you pull yourself up with the abdominal muscles. You are a bit higher than the shoulder blade. If it's not happening, if you cannot do this, you will place your head down and you will work with the head down. Your abdomen will contract less, but you will be less likely to hurt your neck. Okay. So it's optional. Also, how low you will go with the legs, it's optional. If I'm going really low, but I'm losing this contraction, and my lower back peels off, and my belly bulges out, then I am not working properly. So you always need to double check at least these two things. We have a little bit more, but this is like a quick fix that you need to be neutral with your neck. If you are down, you imagine that you are holding something like a knot here, so you don't crunch it, you don't lose it, and if you come up, you are directing your look around knee level, like diagonally. Okay, first exercise is a single leg stretch. So with the exhale, you reach out, pulling your navel in, knee pelvis on alignment, and then change. You are keeping an imprint, you are pulling this together. And now for the sake of simplicity, I'm only having the hands around the knee. I could have many other way, but let's do it this way now. So you could continue. If your neck is painful, place it down. You are probably not doing it good, and I am not next to you to check on that. So if your neck is painful, place your head down and you continue with the head down, just reaching out. If that is easy, you can lower deeper, but there is a chance you did not contract deeply enough. So that was a few things about the single leg stretch. That was first. Second is crisscross. So with the exhale you come up, hands behind the head, pulling the navel in, and then you go to opposite knee and you reach out with the other leg. So here, you exhale as you go to the side. Your lower back is completely staying in contact with the mat, but your upper body is moving. So I show it from behind. And I show what is the fold. So this is what I'm seeing a lot. So you are not supposed to sway from side to side, because that is really bad. So keep the lower back imprinted. Move with the upper body. So that is one variation. You could also have the legs in the tabletop to simplify it. You could have the legs down in the mat. And maybe you could reach sideways. That would be another oblique exercise, but there are many. So the possibilities are really, really endless here. Take an inhale again, with the exhale come up, navel pull in. And let's just simply do double leg stretch, only squeezing the inner thigh in, and inhale back. In classical Pilates, it's a lateral rotation. In Stott, it's more with the legs squeezed. So what I see here a lot is this, and this kind of swaying all around, like pulling the neck. It's really bad. So you really want to have stability there. You are not peeling off from the shoulder blade. As you reach out, you control. You cannot have this kind of movement into it. It will hurt your neck. So that is kind of the easiest way to do it with the hands here. Or if it's complicated, you lower back down. You don't hold your neck if it's painful, and you just reach out. All the abdominal exercises, the higher you go, the easier it is. The lower you go, the harder it is. And of course, you want to go low while you maintain the connection here. So that was the third exercise, the double leg stretch. Let's see just one other version of it. That's quite common. So with the exhale, you reach like you would take off your head, and then you circle around. Circle around. You always reach from a center point, like you would be a book opening, both with the legs, both with the arms, same distance from a center point. Let's just see two more to be sure. Last one. And then release. Okay, we go for the scissor. Reach up. With the exhale, roll up, pull your navel in. And here, okay, Stott and the classical or contemporary Pilates can be different. But all the time, you would like to have the tailbone down, and you never want to pull your neck like this, because I see a lot those movements. So you can have, for example, double time. Notice that my upper body is not really moving. At least I hope. Okay, so the fourth would be like this. I see it all the time because people would like to go close to their legs. Okay, so might be also that you don't have that much flexibility on the hamstring, but you try to keep the tailbone down because maybe your leg will not come up like that. Okay, so you just stretch, stretch, inhale, center. Stretch, stretch, inhale, center. You could also do like with the head down, just lowering one leg, engaging the core, inhaling back up. Other one, and back up. In the scissor, the flexibility of your hamstring is a big challenge. I see especially guys struggling with that, or practically anyone who feels tightness here. Because beside that thing that you are possibly pulling the neck forward, there are people who are pulling their tailbone up. That looks like this. I exaggerate. It can be smaller also, just a little peel up, but it happens. Third thing I also see, losing the squared alignment of the hip and pulling up one leg. Okay, so take care. Imprint, hold the neck, don't move with the upper body, don't leave your table. Voila, that's all. And then we will have just lower and lift. That I didn't see it in Stott Pilates, only from my contemporary routine. With the exhale, you are lowering down, pulling your navel in, and inhale back up. Again here, if you are sure you are still working with imprint, go lower. Personally, I don't think I can go lower because of the shape of my lower back. I'm slightly lordotic. Just one more time to be sure. So here also, what kind of things can happen? You will lower your legs without control. Your lower back slightly start peeling up. Here there is a hole. Here you lost all the muscular control. This is bulging out. And you're sliding down with the head. These are all bad. You constantly need to double check if your head and your upper body didn't change the positions during the movement, and if your lower back stayed imprinted and your belly scooped in. What else to remark on this, just as a quick introduction, is that in Pilates we are exhaling with pursed lips. So it's like a gently open lips, squeezing out the breath. And usually this exhale is happening in the fourth. So the fourth in the abdominal series is always when you lower your legs. You are really encouraged to learn this Pilates abdominal series, because it's going to come up in a lot of workout routine. They use them with functional training and with even with yoga. So they are so common, and they are so commonly executed wrong. It's really nice to have a general overview of them. I will have a Pilates series also attached as a bonus track with this, like a 30-minute version. So you will understand it maybe even more. Thanks a lot, and see you soon. Bye.